So for the first question about the accuracy rate, right now we use MRI that to increase the accuracy rate. So before the MRI, we have a cognitive examination assessment and to check out the patients.
I just don't know how to build,
because
I have no idea what he said, but how about if I just answer? I'm worried about time, so I'll just answer very specific.
So you asked specifically about the U.S. The diagnosis is very difficult around the world.
Do you want to do this? We'll do it real time.
你刚才问到了这个美国的诊断，其实在全世界的诊断都是非常困难的。
The difference between China and the rest of the world is that florbetapir, which is the tracer for amyloid plaque, it is called Amyvid, is the branded name, is available for commercial use in the US, Europe, and Japan.
这个中美的这个关于示踪剂这方面的区别就是在于美国、日本和欧洲他们这个示踪剂已经是商用化了。
China has different regulations than the rest of the world for the use of in vivo diagnostics for research.
所以中国呢和西方国家在in vivo 这个诊断这方面有政策法规上有不同。
So we are still waiting for official approval to be able to use florbetapir in China. Today, most studies have to be done with lumbar puncture instead.
这个我们现在呢还是在等待官方的对于示踪剂的批准。所以目前的话，我们用这个 lumbar
cerebral spinal fluid
腰的创伤，
对，
创伤的检查。
So recently, through a partnership with a Chinese company called Jing Imaging, we have been able to get florbetapir into one or two class 4 hospitals for use for research.
所以目前呢，我们也和中国的一家叫 Jing Imaging 的这个医药公司合作，这个做这个检测。
So that's the tracer for amyloid plaques. We have not yet had the tracer for tau tangles used in China.And it is just used for research purposes right now in the US, Europe, and Japan.
刚才呢我说的是这个蛋白样斑的这个示踪剂。我们现在 ,what was the next one?
For tau tangles.
哦、oh, ,tau 那个示踪剂呢我们现在只是作为这个研究使用。还没有进行商业化。
你好，我的问题是针对那个企业这一方面的，就是大多数的阿尔兹海默症临床试验都没有取得理想的效果，然后很多药企就退出了该领域。我们理来是如何看待这一现象的？并且就是在过去我们的研发过程当中也经历了几次临床试验失败，我们有没有就是考虑过放弃这一方面的研发？或者在今后的这个阿尔兹海默症这个领域的战略布局，特别是资源投入这一块是否有所调整
So about the past research and development, we actually confronted with some failures about the R&D for Alzheimer's. So do we have any modification for our future strategies in the investment of the R&D in this respect?
So I think the first clarification is that we call them negative studies, not failed studies.
首先呢，我想澄清一下，这个不叫做失败，这叫做负面的学习，负面的研究，阴性结果。
The reason for that is that a failed study is a study that fails to give you an answer. A negative study actually gives you an answer and allows you to learn and move forward.
区别在于这个。